I'll drive it out there.
So I'm about to sell my car and I'm looking for something under $4,000.
Did you go in and ask how much you want for it?
He's
at the house probably. You know, probably sleeping.
No, first the podcast gonna be back on file?
It's rough for here today. Wasn't it? What do you need it for?
I got some scratches.
He don't care, he told me he didn't care if you sold it. That's what he told me.
So after the Marine Corps, did you ever expect that you'd be doing this back home?
No. Had no idea. I got out and I did some contracting first. I worked for a company called Oscar Technologies. I worked training guys getting ready to head over on thermal systems. I did that for a year. I liked it, but there's a lot of politics in it. It's a lot of BS that goes with it. I mean, not with Oscar, but just with the job. So, did that for a year. Worked for BAE for 3 months. And then, the same BS with them in the industry. So, that's why I like this the most. You don't see anybody telling me what to do around here, you know? Especially somebody who doesn't know more than me. That's the worst part about people telling you what to do. And I get to work with good-looking guys like Adam.
Yeah. It's funner, ain't it?
Oh. Always.
Can you see yourself doing this for the rest of your life?
I could. Definitely. A lot of people are like, what are you doing, you know? That's the biggest thing is everyone's like, you know, they're trying to hook me up, give me jobs and whatever else.
Like what?
Just different companies. Like kind of going back to the industry kind of. But I don't think they understand that I don't really want to do that, you know. I'd rather do something I like doing. I mean, of course, I could go make a lot more money doing that stuff, by far. But how much, you know, with this job, I work so hard at night, I can go to sleep. I'm so tired. And it's never the same.
Putting the connectors in your mouth so I can't ask you any more questions.
Yep. Ask Adam some questions. I think he wants to answer some.
Is So
he already had me. I already told him everything.
You who's the better looking you. Between you two?
Adam? Oh gosh, the camera, I'll tell you that.
Guess that's why I thought that's why they were following you.
Following who?
Following you with cameras.
Yeah. Okay, I look better.
Reports on TV. This area of the country is always the worst for.
Can we go see and find a piece of food?
If Troy was here, he'd be yelling right now.
So just sort of to revisit that question that everybody seems to ask about what your chosen life is after the Marine Corps and you know being nominated for the Medal of Honor. Is it because everybody else has a different conception of what your life ought to be?
I think it is. I really don't understand it. You know, I guess it's part of the thing is I don't see myself as any different than I was before, you know. And I see, okay, so I'm getting an award. But for some reason, everyone else just thinks that I guess it's because they're so honored. I don't know. They're so happy to be around me or something, but they just feel like I should have a free ticket. It's what it seems like they want. And I'm like, you know, if I get a free ticket on my own, like I do something good or I make my own business and I make a lot of money, then I'll use that free ticket, but I won't use a free ticket off of the Medal of Honor. That's definitely not going to happen.
And why is that?
Because the price that was paid for that, it's not for me. If it was for me, I might use it, but it's not for me. It's for the guys that died and their families and for the people fighting, you know?
So you think, it seems like everybody else thinks that a Medal of Honor should be an automatic elevation in life for you then.
Exactly. That's what they seem to present it as. But that's the furthest thing from the truth.
At the end of the day, what do you want to come out of all this?
That's a good question. I'll have to get back on that one.
Well, just watching you work and seeing your hands come into the viewfinder and so on, you're talking about the price was paid, and every time you're lifting your hands and working on those wires, those names on those bands are the guys that you're talking about, right?
Exactly. That's them. I haven't taken them off since I got them. You see my...
And when was that?
About a year... A little over a year ago. I've been in arguments at airports many times.
Over those bands. Oh,
yeah.
Because they make the things go off?
No, they don't make them go off, but they want them taken off anyways. So. I mean, that's the least I could do, you know? Those guys. They're all dead. They gave their lives. The least I could do is wear two bands around my arms with their names on it, you know, to remember them.
Which bands have which names?
The one on my right hand has Lieutenant Johnson and Gunny Kennefick, and the one on my left hand has Doc Layton and Gunny Johnson.
Are those forever?
Forever.
You didn't have any bands on your hands. Nobody died when you got this.
I wouldn't have got it. It's just, let's just face facts.